Hello, and thank you for spending time with us to learn about Amazon ElastiCache, AWS's high-performing caching service, all in memory and compatible with open source Redis and Memcached. A cache fundamentally exists to relieve pressure on the primary database by serving frequently accessed data to applications. Not only can this dramatically reduce infrastructure operating costs, it also provides significantly better application performance, improving customer experiences. I'm Ed Cotton, Senior Worldwide Go-to-Market Specialist for in-memory databases. I'll be providing upfront business context and then passing it over to Roberto, my colleague and Specialist Solutions Architect, to dive deeper into the service. Amazon ElastiCache is compatible with open source Memcached and Redis. Redis was voted the most loved database 5 of the last 6 years by Stack Overflow and has over 1 billion downloads. ElastiCache provides our customers with extreme performance. In-memory is 50 times faster than solid-state hard drives and 200 times faster than disk. ElastiCache is fully managed. All fully managed AWS database services take away the heavy lifting of monitoring, managing, and maintenance, freeing our customers to focus on developing unique applications for their users. ElastiCache is purpose-built to scale and support modern application demands, supporting non-disruptive scaling, adding read replicas and shards, and including unique features like clustering and auto-scaling, allowing ElastiCache to support millions of transactions per second. This is a versatile cache that decreases the time to develop by enabling traditional relational data models by introducing modern NoSQL data structures. And ElastiCache is built to support all relational workloads, saving costs and improving performance on RDS, Aurora, and even self-managed workloads. Save up to 55% in cost and gain up to 80 times faster read performance using ElastiCache with RDS for MySQL versus RDS for MySQL alone. Our testing is also showing similar results for all other RDS and Aurora engines, as well as self-managed workloads. Scaling relational databases is hard and significantly more costly than scaling ElastiCache. The ElastiCache product management team has been hard at work providing regular feature updates to dramatically improve performance, resulting in additional cost savings. Earlier this year, we released enhanced I/O multiplexing, enabling customers to achieve up to 72% better price performance. Another key feature is data tiering, enabling up to 60% price capacity improvement. ElastiCache truly is extreme performance at a fraction of the cost. Feature updates, such as enhanced I/O multiplexing and data tiering, have dramatically improved performance of the AWS's fastest database service, allowing customers to do more with less. With ElastiCache, microseconds is the new millisecond. Additional options, such as global data store, can replace expensive primary data stores deployed across regions and more effectively and efficiently cache the data back to the primary data store, providing significant cost savings. Reserved instances provide steep discounts for planned usage, and no input-output charges differentiate ElastiCache. Pay for only what you use. All of this reduces unnecessary database costs. Now, I'd like to pass it over to Roberto to show us how this works.
Thank you, Ed. Now, let's take a look at how you can use Amazon ElastiCache for Redis alongside your Amazon RDS or Aurora workloads. Let me explain how you can use ElastiCache alongside a primary database with this diagram. When you cache your data, it's not on disk, but on the main memory of the server. And because the data is in memory, you get predictable performance. Your performance for the reads and writes is now in microseconds, not milliseconds, like Ed mentioned before. In other words, a database cache supplements your primary database by removing unnecessary pressure, typically in the form of frequently accessed data. Cache data is always stored in memory, providing that predictable, low latency performance that is 80 times faster than relational databases, and extremely high throughput that can be up to 4 times higher. the cache nodes are much cheaper than RDS and Aurora read-replicas. We will see the benchmarking results and data in an upcoming slide. You can handle performance needs in relational databases by adding more read-replicas up to a certain point. Adding read-replicas might be expensive, especially if they're full copies of your database and reprocessing the same request. When you add replicas, that means you're trying to do different kind of workloads, but for frequently accessed data. In this case, we're removing some of the RDS replicas and providing the read capacity from our ElastiCache cluster. Adding a fully distributed ElastiCache cluster with 6 nodes is less expensive than adding read replicas. Cache increases the total amount of memory available. It has dedicated networking CPU capacity for reads and provides significantly lower latency and much, much higher throughput. And if you're asking yourselves, how do you get the data into the cache? First, let's keep in mind that we're not replicating the 100% of our database data. In the cache, we only need the results of the queries that are frequently accessed. That means there's no need for fully replicating your whole dataset. Caching is usually a more efficient method of replicating your database reads. Before diving into the details, when we say price performance, what we mean is that what is shown on this chart. RDS cost increases linearly for nominal throughput increase, whereas on ElastiCache, the cost remains the same as shown on the center of this chart. And the throughput can increase to much higher volumes as shown by the blue line that represents the ElastiCache throughput. As you can see, we can go over hundreds of thousands of requests per second. According to our tests, we have performed, and that's why we can get up to 55% cost savings and 80 times better performance. Let's take a look at the most common strategy, lazy loading or cache aside. We have a sample SQL query where we're getting some names and the number of orders from a couple of tables. We could use this SQL as a string. That means the key name of our cache, but it won't be the optimal because we will be using about 140 bytes of data. Instead, a digestion or hashing mechanism is preferable. In this case, we're using MD5 for simplicity. So we change our key size from 140 bytes to 32 bytes. We will use this approach by using Python for lazy loading. Going into the demo, first, I want to show you what we're doing for caching Python using FastCache. Let's see how simple it is to add a cache and starting getting the benefits that we talked about. In this case, I'm going to use the FastAPICache open source framework running on Python. I'm going to take advantage of the FastAPICache cache package with the Redis backend to connect to my ElastiCache cluster. All I need to do is establish the connection and then add a decorator to the method in my API that I want to cache and specify my time to leave as the expired parameter. Yeah, it's literally that simple. I encourage you to find a similar mechanism in your programming language of choice and framework. Most modern stacks have similar functionalities. Now, let's go to the console. All right, so let's take a look at what we have done here. First, I'm going to start my process for my API server here behind the scenes, and then we're going to make some requests. First of all, I'm going to also start listening for commands that are being sent to my Redis or ElastiCache. So I'm going to monitor, and then I'm going to start using my API. All right, that was fast. We're actually going to RDS in this case and taking about 11 milliseconds to respond. And below on the left side, we can see that we're making some requests. In this case, they're going to ElastiCache. We're trying to get the data from the cache and we're taking advantage of that lazy loading pattern by hashing our query. But because we didn't find it, we go get it from the source of truth, save it onto ElastiCache for 10 seconds. And all of this time that I talked about, it seems like the data might be already being deleted. So let's try again. And yeah, we're now getting the data back from the RDS cache and it's taking about 4 milliseconds. So, but if we try again, now we're getting data from the cache. So doing that exercise of the lazy loading and getting responses much, much faster. In this case, 800 microseconds. But this was a fairly simple request. Let's take a look on the right side to what our API is built. So we have three different models: passengers, flights, and booking. This booking table has over 50 million rows. This is going to be a lot slower as it grows. And we can see some of the API endpoints that we have here. As you can see, we're going directly to our database. We have a different version that uses ElastiCache in this case, where we have added our FastAPICache, instantiated the connection to ElastiCache on the startup, and all we had to do is add this decorator to our API endpoints for passengers as well as for booking. So let's take a look at some of the bookings for this passenger. Taking three, in this case, a limit of three elements, and it's taking about 6 milliseconds. It's not too bad, but let's take a look at a different user. Let's go and see, and we're taking about 57 milliseconds to get that data. So that's because we're going to the source of truth. If we refresh, now we're getting the data back from ElastiCache, taking only 800 microseconds, going again to that, in this case, about 60 times faster or better performance with much, much lower latency. We can wait for you to get started with Amazon ElastiCache for Redis. You can scan one of the QR codes and take a look at our product page or take one of the free training certification courses, as well as diving deeper into more details in YouTube. We really thank you for your time. And can't wait to see you again.